Good evening. In these lessons we will speak about shell commands. In particular, we will analyze the main command of a Linux bash shell. So, one of the important features of a Linux bash shell is that you can connect to a remote computer. In particular, to connect to a remote computer and to perform an operation that is main login, you can use the SSH command. In the SSH command, you must write SSH and the name of the computer you want to connect. For instance, I can connect to this computer. As you can see, the syntax of the SSH command is the user you want to use and the address, the IP address, of if you want the name of the computer, the DNS name of the computer you want to connect. After you do this task, the operating system of the computer, of this computer, ask to you the password. As you can see, I place the password and I do login. Now all the command I wrote in this PC are command that are sent to the remote PC using TCP and then return back to my PC the reply. So all the things are executed remotely. With exit, I exit from the remote computer and I return to my computer. There is an important option that is the big X options that allow me to remote connect remotely, but allow also me to use a remote shell. So for instance, if now I type xclock, xclock is a program that open a Windows with a clock. As you can see, I execute in this PC with DCP the xclock command, and the xclock command is executed remotely, and here I have as feedback the output of this command. I can also run other command, for instance Emacs is an editor, and as you can see, after a not so big amount of time, in this case, okay, a Windows interface is opened, and now after another bit amount of time I can use this Emacs terminal in order to write a text file. So now it takes a little bit of time, so we can wait, but in any case, after a while, as you can see, I have the terminal that can be used to write the commands. So we can wait a little bit. In any case, it is really useful because I can also run graphical application remotely. But, okay, now I can write. Now I return to my computer and we can start with the basic command. The most important command, I think, is the man command. The man command is manual, a space followed by the name of the command. In this case, man ls return the manual of the command ls, that is a command devoted to list the content of the current directory, but I can also provide some option in order to make particular things. Then another command is apropos. The command apropos search in all the Linux documentation all the commands that are this one, that has a short description, a description that contains ls. For instance, in this case, I don't know where is ls. But ls is probably here in the name of the command is ls here ls is in another part and so on. Then another important command is what is ls at the end write this first explanation of the command ls and in which manual ls is. So the command ls is located on the manual number one. If for instance I use the command what is followed by write, as you can see in the case of write I have two entry on the manual, write manual 1, write manual 2. If I type man write, I enter write number 1 as default, where write number 1 is a command that is not so really used that allow the user to send a message to another user, is like a chat within the operating system. If I want to see the manual of the second write, this one, the one related to the system call write, I have to write man to write, and as you can see I can enter here. So the idea is that you type man and the command you want to see. Then if you see that it is not the real command for which you see the help, you exit. You write what is write. In this case you see that the manual you want to see is manual number 2 and you enter on the correct entry of the manual. Then there is another command that is where is. The command where is say the name of the command, then say this file that is the position in which the manual of the command is located. So when you found when you type man ls you obtain the content of this zipped file, and slash bin slash ls say where the command ls is located. If I type ls bin you see that there are less slash bin that there are in this folder slash bin many many commands. You have for instance the command ls that is the one we see here, the command make dir that is a command we will see in the next minutes and so on. So the idea is that if you write your own C program and then you compile it and you place the executable here in this directory for instance, you can use your program inside the shell. So for instance you can do a program that perform the sum between two numbers, basically do a C program with arg vector 1 you take the you put the first argument, with arg vector 2 the second argument, this command perform the summation between these two numbers and return the result. If you put this command in this directory or in other directory in which the Linux command are contained, you can use forever your command to perform the summation between two numbers. Then there is, we say that where is ls return this one, there is another command that is which ls that return only this part. So the position of a command within the file system. Then we can go. Here for instance, okay, with the command cd I enter a directory. So in this case starting from the root directory I enter in the directory x or x before changes, that is a similar directory that is containing home, scanzo, zero cloud, two cores, and so on and so on and so on. So now I am in this directory. I can in Linux place more than one command separated by semicolon. In this case, the command are executed sequentially, so the first ls, the second ls, the third ls. Actually, I can place the same command or all the different command. For instance, sorry, here. Okay, so here there is the execution of the first ls, then there is the execution of the command date that returns the current date and time, and then there is the execution of the second command ls. So cd dot dot. Dot dot represent the directory of the parent of the current directory, so I am here in this current directory, cd dot dot, I go to the parent. Here I have some files, like this one, and I have some directory. If I type, for instance, lsx, I see the content of the directory X, so the directory X contains such file. Then I can type lsx slash y in the sense that you see here that X contain a subdirectory Y, lsx slash y return the content of Y and so on. If I write ls dot slash x slash y is the same because dot represent the current directory. Actually, the current directory, this dot slash, is embedded at the end automatically in any command. In this case, I explicitly write it, but the output is the same. This is a relative addressing. I can do the same using an absolute addressing in this way. ls home scanzo zero cloud. Remember that if you use the task tab, there is the auto completion. So it's important because I write the first part tab and there is the auto completion of the command of the directory. It is important because fast the way you type inside the screen. And another important thing is that it avoids error on typing long directory. Then two, for instance, with two I have one, two, three, four, five directory, so the operating system cannot complete my directory. I can use a minus and then press tab. As you can see, when I add the minus, there is no ambiguity, so the operating system can complete the directory two cores. Then OS, let's again, there are three directory that start with L. If I add the E, all the ambiguity are removed. U03. Okay, I have two possibility. I have to type one X slash Y. So this ls or this other ls, in this case I use not a relative but an absolute notation, exactly provide to me the same output as you can see here. There are other facilitation on a Linux shell, so there is the tab, but if you use up arrow or lower arrow, you can navigate in the history. So one up arrow is the last command, the second arrow is the last but one, the last but three, and so on. So if you want to reuse a command you already typed, is really really easy in Linux. Then you have the history. If you type the command history, as you see, you have the list of all your command, starting from the first one to all the command. If you use exclamation mark followed by the beginning of the command, you can execute the command that the most recent command that start in this case with WH. So when you type this, the operating system go up. Here there is a match, so the command that is executed is which ls. You have another possibility to call directly a number. For instance, if I want this what is right, I can type here the number 2014. Remember that Linux has a very interesting feature that is the implicit copy. So if you highlight a part of the text, this part of the text is copied. To do the path, you can only press the button in the middle of your mouse. If I press the button, the middle button of my mouse, tac, and there is the execution of the command. Okay, if I want to copy, for instance, these things, I highlight this part, middle button of the mouse, and here is the copy. If I type a command and I don't want to execute it, I can use Ctrl C. And the clear command clear your screen. Now I enter in the directory X. As you can see, in X I have file1.txt, file2.txt. If I type ls file1.txt, file2.txt, the ls command list these two files. If I also add y, it lists these two files and the content of the subdirectory y. Okay. Then I have some other opportunity. There is, for instance, this command. Okay. It can be complex, but first things, any command in Linux has some option. So here you have the list of the option, and you can type option in using a short format or a long format. For instance, here you have the short format that is a minus followed by only one character, by a character, minus A. Or you can have the long format that is minus minus followed by a string. For instance, there is the L option that is the one is used. In the case of the L option, you have only the short format, you have not the long format. And we use in the L option, the ls command use a long listing format. Okay, so exit, I close the shell, there is another shell. So with the ls minus l, the idea is that I want a long format. This exclamation mark star means that I want to add all the arguments that are passed in the previous command. So in the previous command, argument are these two arguments. So this exclamation mark star is substituted by file1, file2.txt. Okay, as you can see, so actually if I type exactly the same command here, I obtain exactly the same output. But in this case, I have to write a less part. Another way, if I want to add an option to a command, with up arrow I can select the command, add the option and press enter. So there are many, many possibilities. Okay, in any case, the minus l format, as you can see, don't list only the file, but add some information. We will see such information next in the next slide, in the next part of the lessons. Then there is also this notation, so exclamation mark dollar. In the case of exclamation mark dollar, this means the last argument of the previous command. So in this case, the last argument of the previous command is file 2. If I want, I can also use this way. Okay. So in this case, dollar, so question mark dollar is the last argument of the previous command. So I write less minus l, repeating two times the last argument of the previous command. So I obtain this one. If I write less minus l question mark dollar file 1.txt question mark dollar, so question mark dollar is this one, file 2.txt. So I will write ls minus l file 2 file 1 file 2. Okay, file 2 file 1 file 2. So I obtain this output in which file 2 is repeated 2 times, but not so important. So as we said, man ls has the same option. We start, for instance, to see this option, minus a. So if I type ls minus a, the ls command lists also the hidden file, where the hidden file are the file that start with a dot. In this case, we have only two hidden file that are default hidden file, that are the dot, the current directory, and the dot dot that is the parent directory. But if I go in my home directory, pwd is print working directory, so it returns the directory in which I'm located. So here I'm in my home directory, that is home stanzio. Here I am in this long directory, that is this one. So in the home directory there are some default hidden files. So if I type ls minus a, ls minus a, as you can see, I have all the file in my home directory that are many, many file, but I have also some file that are file that with a normal ls command are not visible. For instance, here dot bash history that contains the history of the bash. I have some directory, and these files are used usually for configuration of or for temporary file of programs and so on. So ls minus a, I can use the long format minus minus all, I obtain the same result. We saw ls minus l, that is the long format. There is minus big R, that is the recursive execution of ls. So basically I write ls in the current directory, which is dot, then each time it found a directory, for instance d, it analyzed the content of the directory d, d has a subdirectory z, so it analyzes z, and so on and so on and so on. Then I can also use this in the sense minus l is long format, minus a stand for all, so list all the hidden file. In this case I use both the functionality. As you can see, there is the list of hidden file and there is also the list of the other file, so it's the same. Ls minus lt, t stand is for time, and so the file are listed from this one, that is the most recent, to the most old one. In some situation, for instance, if I am in my old directory, I have many files, so sometimes it is good to have the newest file, that is the one you modified lastly, and so probably you want to modify again and so on. It is good to have this file at the end. So there is this possibility, ls minus ltr, so ls with long format, ordered by time, by modification time, but in a reverse order. So as you can see here, I can found the file that I modified today and in which time I modified them. Then here I have two files, file 1, file 2, there is the command copy for this file 3 that given a source file copy on a destination file. So if I do this command, there is a new file named file 3 that has the same content of file 1. The cat command printing the shell the content of the file, as you can see, file 1, file 3 has exactly the same content. So here I have a directory that is named y. I can try to copy y in z, but as you can see, I have an error because if I want to copy all the tree that start the directory tree that start from the Y directory into the directory Z, but in a recursive way, I have to use the minus R option. This way, as you can see, Y contain this file, but sorry, Y contain this file, but also Z contain this file. Y and Z. Y, for instance, contain the subdirectory Z, so if I list y slash z, I obtain the file containing z. If I list z slash z, I obtain the same file. The command copy, so there is the mkdir command that allow me to create a directory. So this way, make dir test, I generate an empty directory named test. The copy command allow me to write a list of file if you want also directory, but if I place a directory, I need to use the minus R option. So here, the syntax of copy is a list of file, directory, what I want, and the last argument is the destination. In this way I copy file 1, file 2, file 3 and the directory y into the directory test. Now if I analyze the content of test, you see that there are exactly file 1, file 2, file 3 and the directory y. Then there is the remove command that allow me to remove a file, so remove file 3, or I can also use a list of file. Okay, so with the touch command I can create files A, B, C that are empty. So if I do keta, it's empty. With the remove command I can remove even more than one file. If I want to remove the directory test, for instance, you see that the remove command provides an error because to remove a directory I can use the rmdir directory. So for instance, I have the directory P. The directory P contains the file ABC. Now I can try to use the rmdir command on the directory P, but as you can see, the command said directory is not empty. So to use the remove dir command, I must have an empty directory. So I have with the cd command to enter in the directory. With the remove command, I have to remove A, B, C. Or if you want, you can use star. Star stands for any file. any file, remove any file within the directory. Now the directory is empty and I can use remove dirp. But if I have a big directory like this one that has subdirectory and again and again and again, it's not so good to remove all the file and then all the directory. So you can use the remove command, but with the recursive option. So if I use this way or this way is the same. If I use remove minus r test, it remove the test directory and recursively all the content. Now test is removed and also the content of the directory test is removed. Now I can here I have a file that is named read protected file. I can try to copy the read protected this file that is named read protected in A and all it works. Then I can Vim is an editor. So in this case I try to edit the file read protected file. And why I can edit it 1 second. Okay, so here I wrote that this file was read protected, but it is not. So there is a command that is named chmod, change mode, that has this syntax, change mode minus r name of a file of a directory. In this case, I remove this r that represent the read permission from the file that was named read protected file. Okay, so now, as you can see, this file has not the read option, so it cannot be read. Now, when I try to copy my file, the computer say I cannot copy it because the file is read protected. It's true because I cannot read the content of the file, so I cannot copy it. Again, here, as you can see, I cannot read the file even with an editor, Vim is an editor, because I cannot see the content. But if I have the permission, I can read the read permissions. Now I can read it and I can also copy it. And as you can see, the A file contains now the content of the read protected file. Here there is the home directory. In this case, I'm the only user of this PC, and so there is only one user in this directory. If this PC is used by me, Pippo, Pluto, Paperino, here I can have more than one directory. So for instance, if I connect here, okay, connect remotely to this PC. Here I have also, there is also the directory home Giuseppe, home WSN, and so on. So there is also another directory that is the directory that is named root, that is the directory of a user that is named root. So there are some things that can be performed only by the user root, but step by step. If I try, so I generate a file that is named x, that is ls-lx, that is empty. Now I try to copy the file x in home Giuseppe. But as you can see, I have not the permission to write or to modify the file of another user. It is the default of Linux. But I have the permission to list the content. So by default, but all the things related to permission can be changed. But by default, each user can watch the content of the home directory of the other user, but cannot modify the file of other user or add file to the directory of the other user. Instead, the directory of the user root cannot modified in any way, but so if I try to copy, for instance, as I said, X in on Giuseppe, I have not the permission, but there is a command that is named sudo, and with the sudo command I can execute the copy command, or in general the command that follow the sudo command with the privilege of the root user. So in this case I can copy the file X also in the home Giuseppe directory. It is important the sudo command can be used only by user that has the possibility. So for instance, if I am the system administrator, I can generate some user that has not the possibility to execute sudo, but since I have this possibility, I type my password, and now if I look to home Giuseppe, there is the file X here. If I use ls-l, see that each file has two things, a user and a group. So we will analyze all this part one by one, so we can analyze it now. But in any case, each file, each directory has a user and a group. In this case, all the file of Giuseppe has user Giuseppe and group Giuseppe. This file is copied as like I am a root, so this file is of root. And also the content of the root directory cannot be analyzed, but if I use the sudo command, it can be analyzed. In this case, the root directory is empty, so it contains nothing, but I can also copy the file X in the root directory, so in this case, I have content within the root directory. As you can see, the sudo command asked me here the password. But when I repeat again this command, it no more asks to me the password. This is normal, and this is due to the fact that each time I execute the sudo command, it starts a timer and only asks me the password if the timer expired. Ok, ls-l. User group, this is the number of hard link that point to this file, but we will see what is hard link in the future. This number is the dimension of the file, so the file UDP client has a dimension of 946 bytes. This is the modification date, and here is really interesting this part because it is the permission you can have related to a file. We will see this in the future on this lesson. So I disconnect one moment. There is a command that is named move. So if I move file 1 in file xyz.txt, the idea is that I rename, I move the content of the file 1 in a file that is named file xyz.txt. So now file 1 disappeared and I have only file xyz.txt. I can also the command move to move files into a directory. So if I take move file2.txt, remember the tab file xyz.txt in I don't know why, I take these two files, I can also put a directory, I take these two files in the directory z and I place all these three elements in the directory y. Sorry, because the problem here is that Y contains a directory that is named with the same name of this directory. So D, what contains D? D contains Z. I can do this way, remove minus for the core Z, Y. In this case I remove, sorry, def is not important. Remove minus R, Z, Y. In this case now the YZ. Remove minus R YZ. In this case the directory Y does not more contain the subdirectory Z, so I can do my move. Okay. I can do my move, now the move command returns an error because the file1.cd and file syz.cd was moved previously. So I perform a directory test 2, I regenerate the file2 and file syz, now I can move file 2, file xyz that now are empty, and for instance the directory d into test 2. Now if I see test 2 contain exactly the things I moved using the move command. So remember cd to enter a directory, cd dot dot to go to the parent directory, cd dot dot to go to the parent directory. I can also enter directory on the directory y. I can use cd dot dot slash dot dot in order to do two step, so to go to the grandparent directory, print working directory, print the directory. There is the tilde operator that represents the home directory. So cd tilde, I'm going here to my home directory. If I write cd tilde slash zero cloud slash two corsi, as you can see tilde represent home scanzio. So I'm going in zero cloud course two course directory that is within the tilde directory here. So now again I re-enter here on this directory, I regenerate with the touch command file1.txt and ls minus l. So the only part remain as to understand to the output of this command is this one. So the first part referred to the type of elements. Minus is a regular file. If I have a L is a link, if I have a S is a socket, but the most important are minus regular file. So I'm analyzing a normal file, or D that is a directory. Poi, then, as you can see, I have three triples. So this first set of three characters, this second set of three characters, and the last set of three characters. So this character has a specific meaning in a Linux operating system, and now I want to show you the meaning of these three elements with a graphical representation. So, as you said, there is minus d link or sockets. Then we have a first set of three elements that we say are R, W, X, R, W, X, R, W, X. So the first set is referred to the user. So in this case, the user has the possibility, for instance, this is referred to file1.txt. So in this case, the user has the possibility to read, write, and execute this file. Then here is referred to the group. So in the example I show you, there is user and group are the same, so Giuseppe, group Giuseppe, Scanzio, group Scanzio, and so on. But I can also perform a group that is named class, and this group contains some user that can be Scanzio, Pippo e Paperino. And I can have a file that has this permission: read, write, execute, read, execute, and read nothing, nothing. And then, so if I do ls-l, I have a file that has these permissions, and then I delete, no, I cannot delete. And then the user owner of this file is, for instance, Pippo, and the group is class. So this means that Pippo can read, write, and execute this file that is named f.txt. Then I have Scanzio, Pippo e Paperino that can, no, sorry, Scanzio and Paperino, because Pippo is the owner, can do all, that can read or execute the file. And then I have another file that is, for instance, Pluto. Since the Pluto does not appartain to the group class and is not the owner of the file, Pluto can only read the content of the file. So here the last set is referred to other. Basically, so read, R is read, write, W write, and X execute. Basically, I can use a binary notation in order to switch on or remove one option. So for instance, if I want to obtain this setting for the file f.txt, I can write a binary number that is 1111010100. So if I set this binary file for the file f.txt, I can set these permissions, but in order to do so, you use the chmod command that has many notation, but the one I show you now, I think, is the easiest one. So in order to perform this setting in the chmod command, I cannot use the normal binary notation, but I need to use the octal notation. So zero, zero, zero. I write all the possibility of three number in binary. This one 101 110 111. So this is the number 0, this is the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So if I want to write 111 is this one, and I have to write change mode 7. Then I have to write here 101, and 101 is referred to 5, that is this one. And finally, I have to write 100, 100 is referred to this 4, and I can write here this 4. So if I write change mode 754f.txt, I set this permission to the file f.txt. I can do more or less the same on the directory. There is only a difference that in the read means that I can read the content of the directory. So I can, with the ls command, I can list the content of my directory. Write means that I can modify file within the directory. I can remove or add new files. The x, when is referred to a directory, is not referred to execute, but is referred to traverse. So for instance, if I have the directory x that contains the directory y and the directory z, for y and z I have read write and traverse permissions. Instead, for the directory X, I have only the traverse permissions. If I am in a directory parent of X, for instance W, so this is my working directory, I cannot type the command cd X slash Z, because I can travel the directory X in order to go to the directory Z, but I cannot list the content of the directory X. So if I do cd X and then ls, I don't know that the directory X contain Y and Z. Okay, so if I have to type this command cd X slash Z, I need to know preventively that the directory X contains inside it the subdirectory Z. So now we can perform some example. So if I type change mode 777 file1.txt and then ls minus l file1.txt, you can see that now the permission of file1.txt that is owned by me and the group Scanzio is read, write, execute for the owner, for the user, for the group and for others. If I type 764, you see that the owner can do all he want. The group can read or write, and other can only read the content of this file. 740, the user can has all the possibility in this file, the group can read, and the other, so in our case Pluto, can do nothing. 644 is read write. I have also the possibility to use another notation, but I think that the octal notation is the most easy to use. So in this case I want to remove the execution permission from the group. I obtain the same things because the group has not the execution permission, but if I place all the permission on this file and I remove the execution permission of the group, you see that I remove this one. Then I can remove from other, from the other user, the execution permission, and as you can see, this is the output. Then I can, for instance, to the user to remove the execution permissions, and then with the plus I can, for instance, re-add the execution permission to other. So as you can see, probably this one is easiest in some way, because I have only to remember this name. But with this way, I can change on a while with only one command all the permission. Instead, with this other way, I need to write more than one command to change permission. Now I create a directory that is named A, exist, a directory that is named B, okay? Then ls-l, I have my directory B that has by default these permissions. So basically group and other can traverse and can read the content of this directory. Then I can change mode a-xb. Now, as you can see, there is not a is stand for all. So for all, remove the travel permission. So now I can enter the directory of B, but as you can see, the permission is not possible. Why? Okay, it's not possible. Okay, it's not possible, sorry, because without this permission I cannot travel inside directory B. But as you can see, I can listen the content of B, so I can read it, and I can also, no, I cannot generate file within B because I cannot enter B. If I read again the travel permission, I can now enter B, and I can create file within this directory. But if I remove from this directory, for instance, the writing permissions, I can list the content of the directory, I can enter because I have the X permissions, but if I try to put a file within the directory or to modify a file, I can modify the file, but I cannot add within the directory other files. So now I enter again into my PC, so scanzio at 103 192. Okay, there is a command that is whoamhi, that is written in this way, that say that I am the user scanzio. Then I can use the command, for instance, So the command su WSN say that I want to change my user from Scanzio to WSN. But in order to change the user of Scanzio to WSN, I have to place the password of WSN, not my password. If I know the password, I can enter. In this case, VMI is WSN. But in some situation, I don't know the password of the other user. But if I am a sudo user, I can do write sudo su. For instance, I don't know the password of WSN and I have to write the password of Scanzio instead of WSN. Okay, so with sudo su e name of the user, with Giuseppe, with the password of the user Scanzio, in this example, I can enter all the user in this system. This is only because I am the privilege of sudo user. Then I exit, I remove my directory B, minus recursive B. Okay, since I cannot remove because I can have not the permission to write this directory, I have two possibility. The first possibility is to use the command sudo, or the other possibility is to use the change mod command to the directory B and to all the subdirectory, and write the permission, for instance, 777. Again, I cannot use this permission, but if I use sudo, I can do it. One second, so B. Okay, I cannot even list. So B is has only the execution permission. So change mode 777B. Okay, now I have all the permissions and now I can also use no, this way the recursive version of the command. Okay, so the recursion version of the command is with the minus big R. So in this way I change with the permission 777 to B and also to all the file within the directory. So now I can use the remove minus recursive B to remove the directory. I can generate another directory. Now, if I do ls minus la, as you can see, I have all the dot and dot dot. These number represent the element, the link that point to this specific directory. So in the case of the directory, it represents the file that are contained within a directory. So in this case, the directory dot, that is the current directory, has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 directory. So this value is 6 for this way. Instead, the parent directory, that is ls.dot, has 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 directory, then all in dot dot, the There is the directory minus a. Also in dot dot there is the directory dot and dot dot, so at the end the content within the directory dot dot is composed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 subdirectory. And for this reason, when I write less minus la, I have that here I have a content of 5. Instead, related to the directory B, for instance, I have a counter of 2, because if I do ls minus all b, you see that the number of elements contained in this directory are 2. Instead, in y, I have two other directories, this one, and this one. If, for instance, I do mkdir yb exists, sorry, yo, I generate another directory in y. So if now I perform ls minus all l, you see that now in y I have four subdirectory. Now I generate a new directory, it is named S. I enter this directory, I generate a file that is named file. So at the end, this directory contains a file that is named file with dimension 0 with this default permission. Then I have a command that is named link command. I can use link file in A. The idea is that the file has a content, so contains some information. Now, the information contained in the file that is named file can be accessed both by file and by A. So, if I write ls minus l, as you can see, this number passes from 1 to 2. This means that I have two files, two names that point at the same content, that is the content of A. So the idea is that if I delete the file A, I don't lose the content of my file because there is another file that point to this file. At the end, if you see, it's the same also for directory, in the sense that the directory is a list of file that point into a given data area. But in any case, now we analyze the file. If we did another link file in B, as you can see, this value pass from 2 to 3. The idea is that A, B, and file point exactly to the same memory area. Now, again, I do more or less the same, but in this case. So this is a normal link. I link the content of file B of file to the name B. I link the content of file to the name A. In this case, A, B, and file are the same things. Instead, when I place a symbolic link, link minus symbolic, the output is this one, that is something different. And which is the difference? Here A, B and file are the same things. Instead, C is a file that contains a name, and it contains the name of the file to which it points. So the file C contains the name file. So when I open the file C, the operating system knows that this is a symbolic link, and it knows because there is this L options, and open the file with name file. So it opened this file. But there is a big difference. You see that here the dimension of C is 4 bytes, because 4 bytes are exactly the letters of file 1, 2, 3, 4. If I write something in A, so I write the word hello in A, if I do ls minus l, as you can see, I wrote in A, but also B and file change accordingly. Now, if I open C or I do cut C, since it is a symbol link, the operating system take the name file, so open the file with name file, and as you can see, it retard the content of A, B, and file, that is the same. But if I remove file, now the information contained that was contained in file and it is now contained in A and B can be accessible by means of A and B, because you see here the dimension of A and B that are the same data are 6 bytes, and the count, the number of pointer of this data point is 2. Instead, here from blue it passed to red, because in this operating system know that there is a symbolic link C that point to a file that is named file, but the file is not in the file system. So if I write cat A, I obtain hello. If I write cat C, I obtain an error because there is no file, in the sense that C point to file that does not exist. Remember that if I modify A, then write hello 2 for instance, at the same time I modified also B. So I want to return again, because I explained in not a good way the part related to the directory. But the directory, in Linux, the directory B, is only a list of file. So this directory, I'm now in the directory dot, this one, and the directory dot contains basically this list of file of our directory. So a directory is a file that contains a list of file and directory. This data, that is the list of file of directory, can be pointed by different directory. So from B I can enter this directory using dot dot. If I am in the directory scans.it, I can access this directory again using dot dot. If I have in the parent directory, this one, I have an entry of the directory X that can be accessed with X. So at the end, to enter the data area of this directory, I have many possibilities that are starting from the children directory or from the parent directory. So now I want to show you other command. For instance, here I have a file that is named long file, that longfile.txt is composed by a big amount of byte, as you can see. There are some commands to show the content of the file. So we see the command cat that put all the file into the terminal. But if the file is really long, it's complex to use the cat command. So there are other commands. For instance, the last command that, as you can see, show me the first part of the file, and then with the arrow I can move up and down and see my file. With the command Q I can quit. A similar command is the command more. Again, now the command more is more good because with enter or with space I can go down, but there is no possibility to go up. So basically use the less command. The cut command I put inside the file one file hello and word in this second file. So if I do cut file one.txt, I have hello, but also the command cut can be used to concatenate two files. So if I use cut file one.txt, file 2.txt, I obtain the content of the first file followed by the content of the second file. If I use this notation, I take the content of these two files, and we will see in the future, but in any case I redirect it inside a file that is named T. This way I generate a new file that is named T that contains hello and world. So, long file is a long file. There is a command that is named add longfile.txt that print the first 10 lines of a file. I can also use the minus option, minus n3. In this case I print the first 3 lines, in this case I print the first 12 lines, and so on. I have a similar command that is the command tail that print the last 10 lines. Again, I have the possibility to use minus n3 that print in this case the last 3 lines. I have also the possibility to use minus n minus 3, but okay, do exactly the same. Ok, instead, if I use, instead of minus 3, plus 3, the command tail prints all the line with the exception of the first 3 line. Yeah. Now I copy longfile.txt in l2.txt. There is a command that is named diff that can check the difference between these two files. So as you can see, there is no difference because are the same, but I can modify the file l2 in some way. For instance, I can delete the 10, I can add 2 times the value 20 or another value, 25, and I can open the other file that is named longfile.txt, and for instance I can add in this one the number 0. So now I can run again the command if and see you the output. So this output say that on line 1 there is a 0 in this minor, means the file on the left that is not present on the file l2.txt. Then again there is a 10 that is present in this file and is not present in this other file because I delete this line. And there is an addition, so I add one element that is the element 25 in the file line2.txt. It's interesting because these allow me to obtain some indications about the difference between two files. The command word count count the number of line, the number of words and the number of column in a file. Here the number of line and the number of word is different because if you see longfile.txt, there is this line that is composed, is one line, but is composed by two words. So this is because I have this plus one. Then there is the minus L option that prints only the number of lines that can be used also with minus minus lines. Then there is the word options that can be used also with minus minus words that prints the number of words. And then to print the number of characters, I can use the minus C options, or not the minus character option, but the minus bytes option. There is the command df, that is interesting because say how many spaces free in your disk. Usually it is good to use df dot because dot is the current directory, so it show how many spaces free in your in the partition of your disk in which the dot directory is stored. Ok, so basically I use the 98% with the minus h, h stand for human readable, you see the availability or the data in gigabyte, megabyte and so on. We see the command date, there are really many commands. There is the command cal that show you the calendar. Cal 2020 show you the calendar of this year. Cal 10 2020 see the calendar of October, of November, of December. We see the clear command. The nest lookup command is good because show you this is one, the IP address given a name. It is also interesting the wget command because for instance in the web server scans.txt.it, sorry, I have a file that is named ip.txt. This way I can automatically download connected to the web server the file ip.txt and see it. So actually the wget command has the possibility to get any file from the internet, pictures, videos, so on, and also with some option also the ability to show, just to download directly all the site. Ok, thank you for your attention, sorry if I made some small imprecision, but I hope that we learn many commands that are useful to you to start to use the Linux shell. Thank you and bye.